Welcome to What's It Worth Palm Springs. We're at the Canyon Plaza South Flea Market on Saturdays. We're right across from Target in Cathedral City. I'll be your host today along with two experts who will evaluate antiques, paintings, furniture, anything that local people have brought down to find out what's it worth Palm Springs. Hi, I'm Bill Feingold. I'm here with Jackie Berman, and I'm here with Kyle Husflone. Kyle is an expert. Tell us what your expertise is before you look at what Jackie's brought us.
Basically, I was an editor with Antique Trader Publications for over 36 years. Moved out to Palm Springs and worked out of a home office a number of years ago. And now I'm basically freelancing. So I have been collecting for over 40 years and done price guides and articles on antiques since 1972.
That's terrific. Now, our first guest here is Jackie Berman, animal activist, my good friend Jackie Berman.
I am.
And what did you bring us today?
I brought an old Indian doll that was purchased in Arizona at a stand by an elderly aunt in the 1920s.
Aunt Pesha, probably.
Not really.
So, Kyle, tell us about
it. Here and get a photo of it. This is the type of doll that's known among collectors as a skookum doll. Skookum is an Indian-sounding name that was developed when these were first produced. The history of these goes back to 1914, and a lady in the western United States actually first patented what she called skookum dolls in 1914.
Okay.
The first skookum dolls, and they were always dressed as Native Americans, had, would you believe, dried apple heads for the heads. That lasted for about 10 years. Getting into the 1920s, they got a more refined technique and they used what's called composition, which is like a molded, almost paper mache material.
Right.
So they could do much more lifelike Indian heads of this type. This is representing a Navajo. Obviously, she bought this probably on a Navajo reservation. This example has real human hair. During that period of the 20s, they did use real human hair versus later on they used mostly mohair. So this indicates, as you say, it is a 1920s piece. But this particular fellow, given his condition and his age, probably in the collecting market today, could easily sell in the $200 to $300 range.
Wonderful. Wow.
Did you know any of that?
I knew he wasn't from my tribe.
Now we've got him pinned down.
Well, thank you, Jackie. Tribe. Yeah, my tribe. Thank you.
Thank you both.
Well, you're very welcome.
Our next piece is named Bill. No, the piece is the oil painting. Bill, tell us how you acquired this painting.
This has been in the family quite a long time. We inherited it from an aunt who passed away in the 50s, I think. And it's been hanging on the wall, and I thought it was very decorative and looked nice where it was until I heard about what's it worth in Palm Springs, and I thought, well, I'll just take this down and ask these folks what I've got here.
Okay, let's ask. Kyle's our expert. Tell us about the painting,
this
Kyle.
This is a very exciting piece. First of all, when you look at it, it is signed in the corner, C.E. Porter in the year 1901. In doing research, what we discovered is that Charles Ethan Porter was an African-American artist in the 19th century.
Really?
He was born in 1847 and died in 1923. And during the second half of the 19th century, he was widely popular. And you have to keep in mind at that time, of course, any African-American of note, especially like an artist, was very, very unusual.
Yeah.
He specialized in still lifes, both of fruit and flowers. You see a lot of those. This piece is 1901, so he did them as far back as the 1870s, 1880s. This one has a few little tiny spots that might need a tiny bit of restoration, nothing serious at all. In looking up ranges of what Porter works go for today, especially in the East Coast, most of his works, and I saw some that were smaller than this, are evaluated in the range of $20,000 to $30,000.
Wow. How's that sound?
That sounds fantastic.
So this is a piece that definitely needs to have you put special spotlight on it.
Uh-huh.
If for a few hundred dollars you can get the restoration, it's going to do nothing but increase the value.
That's a question I was going to ask you.
Yeah.
Should I have this restored?
Professionally restored. Check with one of the major auction houses, like one of them's in Butterfield in Los Angeles. They will know the people that you should take it to.
I thank you very much for the information.
It's a very exciting
advice,
piece.
And I hope I didn't faint when you told me what the value was.
It's a fabulous piece. Great to see it.
Did you have any idea?
No, I really didn't have any idea. It's been hanging on the wall for years, and just as a decorative item, and
And now it's in a special place, right?
Lock it up. Take it home and lock it up. Thank you, Bill. Thanks a million for coming.
Thank you very much.
Robert's brought us a beautiful piece. Robert, can you tell us a little bit about it?
Well, in 1965, I bought it in Long Beach, California. I think I paid $75 for it. I liked it. It says Austria on the hallmark, but I really don't know anything about it.
Okay, well, that's why Kyle's here. He's going to tell us what's it worth.
We're going to definitely enlighten you today. This is a beautiful figural group, very fine quality chinaware, and it is by one of the better known, more collectible ceramic firms of the late 19th, early 20th century. The actual factory name, company name is Amphora, as in the Greek amphora.
Okay.
There were several companies that this was made in the area of Czechoslovakia, which at that time was Bohemia. And if we turn it up here on the bottom, if they can get a shot, you'll see a number of impressed marks. It has the amphora mark, Turn, which is the city, and then again more amphora marks. These are like design marks. And that's a marking that was used by a company called Reissner, R-E-I-S-S-N-E-R, between about 1908 and 1918. This represents something, an allegorical scene, actually, from Greek myth. If you ever heard of Europa and the bull, this is the bull. That's the god Zeus in disguise, getting ready to carry off Europa, one of his lady loves. And it's spectacular. Now, most of the amphora you see is in very bright shades of gold, browns. You don't see this type of wonderful pastel work and design. It's in excellent condition, has a little signs of wear on it. But I think in the collecting market today, you'd be looking somewhere between $2,500 and $4,000.
Wow. What do you think, Robert?
Oh, that's a good New Year's present, isn't it?
Did you know any of the history of the piece? Did you know anything that you just heard?
Not really. I saw the name under there, and I thought maybe that was her name.
Zeus is disguised.
Zeus is the bull, right?
Zeus is the bull, yeah.
Getting ready to carry off Europa.
Well, thank you. That was good news. That was a good way to start the year.
Very good.
Thanks, Robert.
Thank you.